Major relief this morning for commuters who have to go to work this morning. Light rail, it is back up and running in downtown Minneapolis.
Yeah, they closed it for maintenance, caused a major gridlock in Minneapolis, angering commuters there. Ellery McArdle's in downtown Minneapolis this morning. Ellery, what's going on? Metro Transit's been working to replace those tracks. How's it working today?
Yeah, they've been working hard, and since we arrived here this morning, things have been running really smoothly. You can see the blue line is back up and running, and this is after Metro Transit spent the last week or so replacing track. And we got a glimpse of the really good news yesterday on social media. If you look at this video, they posted this on Twitter and Facebook of them testing out the track. Well, the work they say is crucial and could only happen in the summer. Crews replaced tracks for the first time in 14 years, but it created a huge backup for commuters last week. And now that the major work is done, Metro Transit says it won't happen again for years.
We're going to be okay for more than two decades on this rail. So that's really what we're looking forward to.
Good news there, but there may still be some backups for drivers because a lot of people are trying to avoid the Lowry Hill Tunnel project and they're using the downtown streets. So be mindful of that as people head back to work later this week. Back to you guys.
Glad we have some good news for the light rail. That reopening should ease some of the gridlock we've seen in downtown Minneapolis, but there is still plenty of construction going on. This is what one of our photojournalists ran into this weekend. You'll see it all over the place, even bikers and walkers getting detoured. Tim.
Thank you, Kim. New details are expected to be released this morning in the drowning death of a toddler in Maple Grove. Paramedics started medical care when they arrived at the home in the 7300 block of Orchid Lane yesterday. The child was taken to an area hospital where he died. Now that summer has arrived, plenty of people will be in the pool, but can you tell what a drowning looks like? Nico Santos from our station in Phoenix shows us the signs.
If you see this, would you know what to do?
They talk about adult supervision. I like to say appropriate supervision.
And that's not necessarily you, even if you're a parent. Knowing how to swim yourself is only the first step.
And then someone that knows is comfortable providing CPR and knows how to do the proper rescue.
That's why the Phoenix Fire Department staged this mock drowning rescue to show you what happens and what you can do.
What's going on?
You'll have to act quickly.
Drownings are silent. A child could struggle for maybe 10 seconds on top of the water before they submerge, and that's it.
At any sign of struggle, or if they are submerged, pull the person from the water immediately and designate someone to do that. Someone certified in CPR training should do chest compressions to keep the blood flowing.
The brain starts to die after about 4 to 6 minutes without oxygen.
Kelly Lieberman of the Phoenix Fire Department says CPR increases someone's chances of surviving. And as soon as medics arrive, they'll take over. Jacob Hewlett is the young victim in this scenario. He says he does this to help people understand you have to know now how to react, not when you're thrown into the situation.
If you or your child does not know how to swim, put them in swimming lessons or get them educated.
Well, a quick-thinking crowd of people, they work together, and they're credited for saving two Minneapolis women seriously injured after a driver backed into them at a Taylor's Falls restaurant on Saturday. The women were sitting at a picnic table at the drive-in restaurant, and that's when another woman driving an SUV backed into them, pinning the women under the vehicle, and one was actually pushed into a stream, and she was trapped underwater. Someone cut a length of hose to help her breathe until she was freed. The owner of the drive-in, Wade Vitalis, says some 20 people helped lift that SUV to pull one of the victims to safety.
Because of all these people jumping into action, it was just really it really touched my heart to see people do that.
The women were airlifted to Regents Hospital, and we hope to learn more about their conditions later today. Fans are mourning a racing veteran this morning, the first to be killed at the Brainerd International Raceway in 16 years. The Brainerd Dispatch is reporting that 70-year-old Mel Shaw, a Trans Am race car driver, crashed head-on into a concrete wall yesterday afternoon. This was at the end of the fastest straightaway on the track. Shaw started racing 50 years ago. Tim.
A White House panel studying voter fraud will not be given data from Minnesota. Secretary of State Steve Simon says they wanted voter names, addresses, dates of birth, recent voting history, and details about military status and felony convictions. Simon says he has serious doubts about the commission's credibility and trustworthiness. President Trump has alleged that millions voted illegally in the 2016 elections. Facing heat from constituents and pressure from Twitter and from the president, Republican senators find themselves back home this holiday weekend with no plan yet and no answers on how to replace Obamacare. Last week, the president suggested that Republican senators repeal Obamacare now and replace it later, but some Republicans say they can't vote for the current plan because it's too much like Obamacare.
The bill is just being lit up like a Christmas tree full of billion-dollar ornaments, and it's not repealed.
Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell largely dismissed the suggestion of a repeal-only measure.
Well, Minnesota Twins legend Rod Carew will be honored at the Twins game tonight against the Los Angeles Angels. It's Carew's first trip back to Minnesota since his heart transplant. And in May, we shared the story of Carew's transplant as well as his donor, Conrad Roland. Roland was a former NFL tight end who suffered from a brain aneurysm. Well, tonight, a replica of Carew's 1977 MVP season jersey will be auctioned off, and it will benefit the American Heart Association. Carew will also throw out the first pitch as the team and the fans are celebrating 40 years since that milestone season.
Minnesota Timberwolves picking up a few players over the weekend. Friday night, they signed Jeff Teague to a three-year deal. Yesterday, they added Taj Gibson. Power forward gets a two-year, $28 million contract. Like Jimmy Butler, Gibson played for head coach Tom Thibodeau in Chicago. Gibson's 32, but it's a good defender who knows the Tibbs system well. And the newest Timberwolf is causing some issues for an Illinois man. The phone number Jimmy Butler gave out during his introduction last week is just one digit away from Michael Burns' number.
No.
Burns says his phone has literally been ringing off the hook.
Oh, that's funny.
With people asking for Jimmy Butler.
I love that.
I hope he gets something out of the deal.
I think that's awesome. Except he doesn't.
Dial, if you're going to try either of those guys, dial carefully.